description or the Zang. But the composition, they are lacking in terms of the diamonds.
They should have went for Carry.
Carry? But they jungle? Already got Beatrix.
Oh, well, I got it right, I guess, but this is going to be a Carry in the jungle for the side of Geek Fam.
I don't like this one because it's going to take some time.
You're up against
for
Grok.
Carry to, yeah, that's right.
And
Grok will going to harass you over and over in the jungle.
Aside of that one, like, it's like very, very squishy pick coming from Team Geek Family here. A lot of options to, like, locking onto Kari. When we know that actually Phantom Steps from Kari is just, like, not too long for the range. Like, the ability to go out from that one is just gonna be very hard for the Kari. It's just, I don't know if Geek Fam gonna make it into the first game.
Yeah, there's so much pressure on Wawa. Franco as well, Baxia on Albert. This is literally the three men, the three heroes that can dive you from level one.
Yes, that's why. They need to defend this first 5 minutes. And it's gonna be tough for Geek Fam, but let's see what do they have in their pocket right now.
Oh, personally for me, man, I don't think they have anything in their pocket aside from that front-to-back composition that they really need to rely on. But ladies and gentlemen, it's time to dive in to the portal. Into the land of dawn we go. RRQ already going into that mini jungle. Wait, Renvi is in the roamer position. What is going on? Wait. No. All right, Renvi is in the XP. Tyler. And actually, Xuan winning out in that top side.
Wait, first blood by
Geek Fam. Wait a minute. We might be wrong here on Wawa.
Yeah, R7 into the EXP. It's not for the roamer, for the Grok here.
Yeah, I think like the ability of Grok to clear the wave minion is just like faster compared to the Franco. So maybe that's the way that they choose it to do it as the Grok, as the XP laner.
But the pressure is already, you know, Albert is just taking the creeps from Geek Fam. And the orange buff is just still there by Geek Fam. So I think there will be some delay here for Hans to take all of the jungler buff.
Well, remember what we said in the keys to victory. RRQ needs to still stay disciplined. Yes, they are up against the lowest standing team here in MPI Season 9, but that doesn't mean you can go full disrespect mode. Hans is definitely a monster here, especially on a carry pick. But look at his jungle, like you said, everything was taken away from him. He's not even going to be able to hit level 4 without the gold buff.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough time, but still, they are playing with the 5 members, so I think like Geek Fam still have the chance here.
With the Kari that actually can, like, maybe if they snowball a little bit in the early game, I think like Kari will be like very, very good hero to pick all of the hero coming from RRQ Hoshi, but it depends on how they are able to get the farms that is needed by the Hans, because it's also taking the Demon Slayer emblem here, which need a lot of farms compared to that one. And also, whenever they caught in the war, big war especially, it's gonna be the position is what matters here from Team Geek Fam itself.
Absolutely, but RRQ, they're already going into this one. Renvi goes to the backside, but it's gonna be R7 with the wild charge, gonna be able to cancel that backside, and look at the Windblade and the Windstorm connecting at will. It is going to be Albert picking it up as well. Renvi has nowhere to go, and that might just be another kill picked up. Clay goes in for Windblade once more onto Rupture, but a 1-0 trade with the turtle as well. It seems like Geek Fam don't even have the pressure to contest.
Yeah, it's just like the position is just so bad. The barrier that is being opened by Grok is just like so good, along with the Iron Hook coming from the Fiend right there with the Franco. And the way that they are taking Kari first into that condition is just a big gain for RRQ Hoshi, because we know that basically jungler needs to be perfect.
Ooh. Oh, wow. He reads him like a book, Xuan. He was a little children's book there. He just opened it, Vin goes for the hook, and he knows that he wants to try to dodge it. Skylar pushing in the lane now, and it's already starting to look very, very grim for Geek Fam.
Yeah. That is a very nice hook there. I thought that it's gonna miss, but apparently, like, Finn hook is just really, really on point. And look at this one. Always just keeping the pressure into the jungle.
Taking everything, Rupture trying to open up the map, but like we mentioned, he's not really that tanky. He gets hooked, he's dead.
Yes, one hook, one down, because there is no huge body for Geek Fam in the front lane. They all playing for pick off here. Cho as the pick off, right? Who's gonna take all of the damage? Meanwhile, Hans can deal a damage.
It's not gonna be like that. They want to close the gap between the heroes here. That's why they're picking over Valir with a Searing Torrent and also Burst Fireball. They want to try to make all of the movement, especially for Yves with the slow evac and also like the damage that is given from Curry. But just like what you've mentioned, it's not going to be that easy.
Yeah.
Gonna be very hard, but still, can I do the Rupture?
Yeah, Albert goes in for the damage. Rupture will just be Retribution, and that's another kill picked up for RRQ. But on the bottom side, though, R7 is caught in a bad situation. Renvi just deals a little bit more damage, but he is going to be able to get out of that one. Another free turtle goes to the hands of RRQ, and these are just objectives being picked up all across the map. Albert is already two levels ahead of Hans.
It's just a huge, huge, huge difference here, along with all of the jungles that is taken directly for Team Hercules. But the Iron Hook again connect, and also the Real World Manipulation being open. Swan trying to run away, still able to go back, but the Real World Manipulation able to take him down.
With the Windblade as well, Albert goes in for a re-engage with the Chill Unit connecting. That's going to be the Windstorm all the way to zone them out, and Rupture will not be able to get out of that one. Renvi goes in for the Jeet Kune Do, but he is going to be canceled away. Renvi now, he's trying to look for Albert with the pickoff. He has the Flicker, but he doesn't choose to use it. He keeps the Flicker for Christmas.
Oh my god, that's a very, very nice flick with Hook. And the Wild Charge at the mid lane, happened there?
Yeah,
oh my god, Yves. It's a 1v2 and R7 just winning the fight.
It's a disaster for GeekFam at this point, right? They're really confused at what they're trying to do. It feels like when they want to go in, a few members just want to go back. It's a complete miscoordination, I feel like, from GeekFam.
I feel also like they do not have any power here at the early game. They need to farm one or two items before they could make a fight. And that's what RK Hoshi do. They just keep harassing over and over.
Yeah, and
holy the damage.
The damage that is given from Clay is just so huge already. But the thing is, if you mention like they want to farm for one or two items, remember, this is a two marksman. There is still blade armor that can be used for three heroes even here. Albert, Finn, and also like R7.
All of them will buy blade armor, I guess, but R7 will. Look at R7 item, 3 Legion Sword.
Wow.
Oh, that Finn will be taken down just like that with that movement with the middle station, and even double kill here.
Yeah, that's a double kill, but Clay might just go for the Windblade Windstorm combo. Rupture is gonna get taken down with nothing contested here. Albert, where the turtles is poisoned, he doesn't take any damage from the Beatrix. He basically heals him up there, and R7 in a 1v2. Let's see what he can do with the sword that he has. Han's gonna be able to burst him down. Clay goes in for the knockup, but will not be able to connect onto him. It is gonna be Vin with Albert as well with the shield unity. That's gonna be the damage coming in. And see you later, Renvi. You had a good time. Killing spree picked up from the side of RRQ. Hoshi, a 4.5k gold lead built in 6 minutes.
It's not only that, the 3-level gap between the jungler here will play a ton of factor for RRQ Hoshi.
So it means that the Grok with the 3 Legion Sword, it's gonna be like Blade of Despair along with the Malefic Roar?
I think he's gonna buy like 5 Legion Sword.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because,
that makes sense.
Yeah, because one physical attack equals 0.7 physical defense.
Mm-hmm.
It's still a good item, I guess.
Yeah, just and also, item.
It's the item that's cheaper.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, but when you want to finish like Blade of Despair, it costs like 1,960,
yeah.
Right?
It's really expensive.
Just get 5, right? Yeah. Get 5 of the same. Oh my god!
Luckily, Vengeance.
Has Vin missed the hook? I don't think he's missed a single hook in this game. And again, this is what you can do, you know? But again, it's a 5.6k gold lead. RRQ completely controlling the map right now, and they're just looking for sieges at this point. GeekFam, they're gonna have to pull a miracle to take this game over. Hans will need to get his items as well as Schwan. And I don't know what Vince is supposed to do. I don't think he's going to be able to pop the Real World Manipulation at any time.
It's going to be a hard time. And it's kind of with the BOD. So I would love to see the item from R7 here. Did he finish his 5 Legion Sword first? Or did he go for the BOD and also Malefic Roar after that?
Probably. If they don't want to, like, if he doesn't want to, he just can go like to all Blade of Despairs. It's just going to be very expensive. But if he's on the lead like this, it's still possible for them to do so.
And also, Clay item is already done. The Lightning Truncheon. It's going to be tough for GeekFam. Vengeance Flame, yeah, that is Vengeance Flame.
Wow, this is really, really tough, but R7 now jumps into the backside, gonna be able to deal the damage to the Wild Charge as well, and that's gonna be hot taken very low. Vin gonna be able to get away, but it's gonna be R7 kicked back to his team. 1-4 though, that's a tank. He walks out scratch free, and RRQ, they just stole the buff away for nothing. They didn't even use the flickers aside from Vin.
Yeah, they're just walking inside of the Real World Manipulation.
Also, we know that actually, Grok, the heal when they're nearby the wall is just going to be increasing, right? That's why it's just like very hard to take down that R7 and five legends worth.
Five legends worth.
Congratulations
that's
for that one.
Yeah, this is a very cheap option. You guys could try it at the rank. I must say, it's a very, very cheap option for Rogue especially.
Look at the damage. Look at the damage. There you go. That's the damage. Take half HP off a tank. And that is the suppression to take him down. And Beerus Bash is going to be popped right there as Hans jumps in. But it's not going to be the kill picked up. Albert goes in for the re-engage. And that's the backside completely torn apart. RRQ, they're not even going to lose a single member. Vin is still alive. Oh man, they're gonna need some food to get back in this game. They're gonna have to order with Grab using promo code MPLIDXGRAB. Yeah. I don't know what to say, it's a 7k gold lead and it feels like GeekFam have already lost from the drafts.
I do agree with you, and right now with the lore that is handled by Team RQ Hosey, even not 10 minutes yet for that one. They're just like claiming everything, every objective that is possible, the turret. The inner turret, even the one that is left in the middle and also the top lane. But look at that one, the reward manipulation being open. Vein will be taken down, but it's a lot of resource to take one member down from RQ Hosey.
That was five ultimates. They used five ultimates to get a Roamer and Skylar. Yeah, with R7 just wreaks havoc. Albert, five ultimates to kill a Franco? Yep.
I don't know about that, man.
It's a lot of resource. It's very expensive movement to just take Vein down.
Yeah, it's just
it's not even a shutdown.
It's just a Franco. I mean, like Finn could escape that if the flicker is ready, but it is on the cooldown.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I guess still a win-win condition here for RQ Hosey.
If it's not gonna be a win condition for them because actually they're losing to the high ground later on because RQ Hosey now giving like one big wave in the mid lane to take over the inner and also maybe trying to get over the base turrets in the mid lane.
Oh, Renvi goes in for the Jeet Kune Do flicker combo. Vin is going to be able to use a flicker as well defensively. Both teams just trying to get pickoffs here, but RRQ managed to get out of Renvi's kick. And that's the Windblade connecting and the turret up top taken down. Only the base turrets left for the side of GeekFam. And Vin goes in for a cheeky hook, doesn't get it though.
Yeah. The positions from Team GeekFam right now is really matter, but they are staying inside of the base without any options to get out and also trying to get over the player of Team RQ Hosey. The Iron U-Hook is just being spammed to get someone from Team GeekFam here to be pick off first before they try to jump in and also dive in into the base turrets of Team GeekFam right now. Well, it's 65 seconds before the second Lord appear in the Land of Dawn. So it can be like taken by Team RQ Hosey because I don't think GeekFam will be able to get out from that phase.
Yeah, let's see the item. Alright, finally, we do not have five legions worth, but...
Almost. Rupture almost gets taken down. Force to use the flicker, but Omawa, I do have one thing that's good about GeekFam here in this draft.
What is that?
They have pretty good high ground with the Beatrix, Carry, and the Yveh with Valor as well. I think their wave clear is actually pretty good, but how long are they going to be able to play this long game of clearing waves?
I mean, like, yeah, they could have a very, very good high ground defense, but that's if RQ Hosey is just playing this more passionately, they could just wait for the Evolve Lord. That's the main concern here. GeekFam, they can't even contest the Lord. You know, like, they do not have the power to just deal with the Evolve Lord.
I want to ask about Hans. Like, the decision-making over making the Demon Hunter Sword is very good because it's what they need to face, like, three tanky heroes along with the Endless Battle. What about the Thunder Battle or maybe another true damage items?
Yeah, probably it's going to be his fourth or fifth item after this one because he really also need the Thunder Battle for the slow effect just to catch out RQ Hosey off guard.
Uh-oh, Conceal is going to be popped by GeekFam to look for R7, but they use all their resources once again to the top side, and RRQ gets a free, uncontested Lord here in the bottom side. I do like the effort, though, from GeekFam. They were trying to look for a pick. They were looking for a trade because RRQ has started the Lord, but I feel like it's a little bit too late to look for those trades. They should have looked for those a little bit earlier into the game.
And I think that they do not have the power to pick up R7. R7 with the power of nature is just immune to everything. He's going to be like anti-CC. And Albert with the Curse Helm. The damage is already there for RQ Hosey. And they could just marching this one out. Just playing this as much objective as they can.
I'm scared actually when they are trying to face over R7. I think like the one of them might be picked off by R7. And R7 can run away easily with the wild charge or maybe the power of nature. But yeah. With this kind of condition right now, with the second Lord is being held by RQ Hosey and gonna go directly to the mid lane of Team GeekFam. Yeah, they have the reward manipulation, they have the Searing Torrent, and they are having the ability to clear all of the minions here. But the management coming from RQ Hosey is just so dope.
There you go. That's going to be the first base turret taken down. Albert using the shield unity to open up the map here as they get pressure for that bottom side. Skylar will be able to push that one in, and that is two base turrets now for RRQ. They might just look for the end here with three base turrets taken down. Conceal was actually popped by Ren V. He's looking for the trade, but only on to that backside, which he is not going to be able to get either way. The mega kill now for Clay as they have picked up Ren V. They're going to try and look for the end here, but the real world manipulation will actually be able to stop them in there. Draxman gets Vince there, and Skylar is there with a gun to take him down. Rupture with a peel, with a wild charge will be able to connect to the backside. Swan needs to use the flicker. Hans gets bursted down, and RRQ in this game. A 14k gold lead before to take Swan down and take the game in the end. They're going to have to get the wipe out first. They're hungry, but no. RRQ to take the lead 1-0 without the wipeout.
Yeah, yeah. I think that RRQ Hosey, they already win the game since the draft. The draft is so strong. They have.
I agree, the draft.
Yeah, they're already adapting to the new patch.
Well, for GiftFam, they are still very using the old kind of draft right there. They're still trying to find out what can they do with this kind of heroes that they pick. But I mean, like, they're supposed to not picking the Beatrix too early. Maybe Kari in the gold lane is so much better, and they can pick someone that is more tankier into the jungle, or maybe as the roamer right there.
And also, like, I think Beatrix here is kind of like some deny pick.
Yeah.
So Skylar should not use the Beatrix here. But
I know.
But because there is some Beatrix pick, they can't use the tank jungler.
Yeah, and they're not picking and also prioritizing the Grom. That is available. The first pick is like Baxia, right? From Team RRQ Hosey. Why they're not trying to pick maybe the Grok plus something?
Yeah, they went for the Beatrix and the Yveve.
Yeah, like why they're not picking over that one? Like maybe Grok and Beatrix is so much better rather than Yveve and also like Beatrix.
Yeah,
I agree. It's a complete disaster from the draft, I feel like. Omar, we said this, you know? I don't think GeekFam had anything to really, you know, contest. RRQ.
They could just delay, but they do not have the answer. They just delaying with Valir. I mean, like, only they could make the pressure, but after that one, after the first blood, nothing else. Like, GeekFam do no pressure towards Albert. And Albert is the one just, okay, I'm just crossing to your jungle. I'm gonna take all of your creeps. I'm gonna take all of your buff.
Yeah. I mean, like, they're supposed to play more aggressively with this kind of draft because they are the one who get the power, such as like with Valir, with the Yveve, with the Void Blast, and also the Void Crystal. I mean, like, they have the chance to do it along with the Cho as well, but they're not.
And also, like, we know Kari, the Marshman, it is not suitable for jungler anymore. I mean, even though, like, Marshman could become a jungler, but it will take a longer time if it is compared to tank. It is compared, I mean, like, Hans is using Ice Retribution.